Immune Memory and the Coronavirus, Part 1, Emergency Response. COVID-19 and the virus that causes it have utterly disrupted our lives across the globe since emerging in humans in late 2019. We're caught between the need to protect others and the desire to get back on our feet, see loved ones, and reopen businesses. The media is filled with questions about vaccine development, if we can use antibody testing to let people go back to work, and whether or not people can catch the virus more than once, all of which can sometimes feel confusing and overwhelming. Our capacity to answer all of these questions is underpinned by a concept known as immune memory. The ability of our body's immune system to remember an infection it's seen before and fight it before we might get sick. To mount an effective and long-term response to the new virus, doctors and scientists called immunologists need to discover how this virus and vaccines to this virus interact with our immune system and establish immune memory. In this series of short videos, we'll explore the fundamentals of the immune system's memory and why understanding it is so important to solving our current medical crisis. The human immune system is composed of a complex network of immune cells, particularly white blood cells, also known as leukocytes. These have many different roles, but ultimately they work together to keep the body safe from potential danger, like a microscopic personal emergency services team. Sources of danger include invasion by pathogens, like harmful bacteria, viruses, fungi, or parasites. The immune system protects us using two approaches, known as the innate and adaptive immune responses. The innate immune system acts first and is made up of emergency first responder cells, signals, and antimicrobial substances, aimed at removing anything which looks harmful. The adaptive immune system consists of specialized cells and their products, which are trained over time to neutralize a specific threat. The innate immune system doesn't require any previous information about the threat, but its less focused attacks can cause more damage to nearby cells. The adaptive immune system is very specifically targeted to a pathogen, but needs prior information about the invader and time to set up an effective response. The exact details of how the new coronavirus triggers our immune system are now emerging, thanks to ongoing medical research. The ability of immunologists to discover these details is vital to understanding the natural development of protection and to create the best vaccines, as well as safe and effective drugs to treat different stages of COVID-19. We know that when the virus first enters the body, it inserts its genetic material into the epithelial cells, those cells lining the upper airways. This hijacks those cells to produce and assemble all of the components required to make copies of the virus. Those hijacked infected cells will eventually die, releasing millions of new viral particles, which start the cycle again. In somebody that's never encountered the virus before, the innate immune system responds first. Leukocytes called macrophages, living in and monitoring these infected areas, eat up bits of virus and dead cell. Alerted to the problem, the macrophages release alarm signal proteins called cytokines, which bring other leukocytes to the scene, including neutrophils and natural killer cells. Inflamed tissue starts to populate with these cells, ready to act. Together, these different types of leukocyte can try to destroy infected cells and prevent viral spread. Epithelial cells can act too, making proteins which sound an alarm, preventing viral entry, or protecting neighboring cells by directly damaging the virus. In the best case scenario, this innate immune response may be able to clear the virus before more significant disease occurs. However, if these responses are not properly regulated, and inflammation becomes uncontrolled, this process can actually start to damage the body. While the innate immune system tries to deal promptly with the viral infection, other immune cells, called dendritic cells and macrophages, start to train the adaptive immune system by showing bits of the virus to T and B cells. There are millions of these T and B cells inside your body, with unique proteins called receptors on their surface. If one of these cells has a receptor that fits with a bit of the virus, this cell gets selected and activated. Once those best fit T and B cells have been identified, they multiply to make clone armies of themselves, all trained to fight this specific threat. Some of the trained T cells identify and kill lining cells infected with the virus. This helps to remove the infection, but needs to be carefully controlled so that it doesn't do too much damage. Other T cells send signals that regulate the body's responses and also help B cells to activate. B cells are unique in that they can make antibodies. These protein tags will stick to the virus. Neutralizing antibodies prevent the virus from entering cells and can help other cells to remove and destroy the viral particles. However, other antibodies can stick to the virus without doing anything of great value. And rarely, some antibodies may even help the virus to enter our cells. Neutralizing antibodies are often the best weapon against viruses, and immunologists are working to understand if these might also protect us against COVID-19. If the innate and adaptive immune responses manage to neutralize the virus, they start to release new signals, which will calm the inflammation, encourage healing of the tissue, and return the immune cells to a monitoring state. These people might have had almost no symptoms of COVID-19, but the adaptive immune system might still form protective memory against future encounters with the virus. You can find out more about immune memory and what happens in severe cases of COVID-19 in our other videos. In this short video, we've learned about the basics of immune system function, including the difference between the innate and adaptive responses and how they interact with coronavirus and with each other. In the next installment, we'll learn about how immune cells remember a previous infection to keep us safe in the future. If you'd like to learn more about coronavirus itself, the role of individual immune cells, how T and B cells are trained and selected, or what happens when immune responses fail, please use the links below. This video is part of a collaboration between the Centre for Inflammation Research at the University of Edinburgh and the British Society for Immunology. Thank you for watching.